Hi my dear students, myself Kedarnath. Welcome to my channel Make Mathematics Simple. So in this session I am going to explain one more trick in definite integration. So look at trick number 3. So integral 0 to pi by 2 sin x power m into cos x power n into dx, where m and n are natural numbers. Okay, so first you begin with denominator. Here, what is the sum of the powers? M plus n. Okay? What is the sum of the powers of sin x and cos x? M plus n. Write that m plus n. Subtract 2. Next, from this number again subtract 2. Continue this procedure till you are getting either 1 or 2. Okay? Numerator. Write 2 brackets. So, first bracket you begin with m minus 1. Sin x power m is there. So, but you have to begin with what? M minus 1. Subtract 2, m minus 3, and continue that procedure till you are getting 1 or 2. Similarly, second bracket, you begin with n minus 1. That is, cos x power how much is there? N. But here you have to begin with what? N minus 1. Next, you subtracting 2. N minus 1 minus 2, n minus 3. Next, n minus 3 minus 2, n minus 5. And so on. Continue that procedure till you are getting 1 or 2. So, this is the procedure. So here you have to start with the m plus n. In first bracket you have to start with the m minus 1. In second bracket you have to start with n minus 1. In all three cases you have to what enough? Subtracting 2. And continue that procedure till you are getting the last number is either 1 or 2. If you are getting either 1 or 2, stop that procedure. Which procedure? Subtracting 2. Okay? That procedure you have to stop. So, whenever you are getting the number, either 1 or 2. So, this is the answer. Suppose, if both m and n are even numbers. If both m and n are even numbers. After doing this procedure, extra you have to multiply with what? Pi by 2. If both m and n, that means if both powers are even numbers, then only after doing this procedure, extra you have to multiply with what? Pi by 2. Okay? Otherwise, don't multiply with pi by 2. If both m and n are even numbers, after doing this procedure, last you have to multiply with what? Pi by 2. Okay? So, you have to multiply pi by 2 only when both m and n are even. Okay? So, example, integral 0 to pi by 2, sin x power 5 into cos x power 4 into dx. Okay, here m value is how much? 5, n value 4. Okay. Then m plus n value, what will you get? M plus n, 5 plus 4 how much? 9. So here you begin with 9. Next, subtracting 2, 7. 7 minus 2, 5. Next, 5 minus 2, 3. Next, 3 minus 2, 1. So after getting 1 or 2, you have to order stop this procedure. Next, numerator, first bracket. So what is m value? 5. 5 minus 1 how much? 4. So, you have to begin with what? 4. So, 4 into 4 minus 2 how much? 2. But we have to stop this procedure because we are getting what? Number 2. Because I told you, if you are getting either 1 or 2, you have to stop this procedure. So, stop this procedure. Next, second bracket. Second bracket, we have to start with what? N minus 1. What is n value? 4. 4 minus 4 how much? 3. So, you have to start with 3. You have to start with 3. Next, subtracting 2. So, 3 minus 2 how much? 1. So, as you are getting 1, stop the procedure. So, now you check both m and n are even numbers. No. If both are even numbers, then only they have to multiply with what? Pi by 2. Here, both are not even numbers. So, don't multiply with pi by 2. So, this is the only answer. So, just simplify this. See here, 3 into 1 get cancelled. See, still any other cancellation? No, nothing is there. Numerator, 4 into 2, 8. divided by denominator 9 into 7 into 5. 9 7 is 63. 63 5 is 315. So thus integral 0 to pi by 2 sin x power 5 into cos x power 4 into dx value is how much? 8 upon 315. Okay. So look at the next example. Integral 0 to pi by 2 sin x power 4 into cos x power 6. Here m value 4, n value 6. Okay. So denominator we have to begin with what? Nana? M plus n. Correct? So sum of the powers. 4 plus 6 how much? 10. So denominator we have to begin with what? 10. Next to subtracting 2. 10 minus 2, 8 into 8 minus 2, 6 into 6 minus 2, 4 into 4 minus 2, 2. So after getting either 1 or 2, what we have to do? We have to stop this procedure. Next, numerator, write two brackets. So first bracket we have to begin with what? M minus 1. What is M value? 4. 4 minus 1 how much? 3. So begin with 3. Next to 3 minus 2 how much? 1. So as we are getting 1, stop the procedure. Next into second bracket we have to begin with n minus 1. What is n minus 1? 5. Because n value 6. N minus 1? 5. Next continuously we have to subtract what? 2. So 5 minus 2? 3. Next to 3 minus 2? 1. As we are getting 1 there, we have to stop that procedure. Okay. So now if you observe, m is equal to 4, n is equal to 6. Both are even numbers only. So as both are even numbers, after doing this procedure, we have to extra multiply with what? Pi by 2 into pi by 2. Because here both m and n are even numbers. Both are even numbers. Then only you have to multiply extra pi by 2. Otherwise, don't multiply with pi by 2. Okay? Now, simplifying. So here, 3 1, 3 2s. Next here, 5 1s, 5 2s. 3 1s, 3 2s. Here, 5 1s, 5 2s. Still any other cancellation? No. So next, numerator, what is left? 1 into 3 into 1, 3. Into pi, 3 pi. Divided by denominator. 2 8s are 16, 16 2s are 32, 32 4s are 128, 128 2s are 256, 256 2s are 512. So that was the answer. Okay. So look at next example. Integral 0 to pi by 2 sine cube x into cos x power 5 into dx. Okay. So here sum of the powers is how much? 3 plus 5 how much? 8. So here we have to begin with 8. Correct? Next step, 8 minus 2, 6. 6 minus 2, 4. 4 minus 2, 2. So as we are getting 2, we have to stop the procedure. Okay. Next, first bracket we have to begin with what? N minus 1. Here, m value is how much? M value 3, n value 5. M minus 1 means 3 minus 1 how much? 2. So, we have to stop the procedure. We can't subtract 2 because directly we are getting what? 2. Okay? So, into. Next to here, n value how much? 5. N minus 1 how much? 4. Okay? N minus 1 how much? 4. Then subtracting 2. 4 minus 2 how much? 2. But we are getting 2, we have to stop the procedure. Okay. Now, here both are not even numbers, so don't multiply with pi by 2. So, this is the only answer. So, any cancellation? See here 4, 2, 4, 2 cancel. 4, 4 cancel, 2, 2 cancel. So, 2 1s, 2 3s. So, numerator is what is left? Only 1 is left. So, 1 upon 8 into 3. How much? 24. So, that was the answer. Okay. So, now look at in this strict particular cases. So, when m value is 1, n value is n only, the integral 0 to pi by 2 sin x power 1 into cos x power n into dx is 1 upon n plus 1. That is 1 upon 1 more than the cos x power. Here sin x power is 1, cos x power is something is there. Okay. Then what is integral 0 to pi by 2 sin x into cos x power? That's something. 1 upon 1 more than that something. Okay. Similarly, here cos x power is how much? 1. Sin x power is how much? M is there. Then what is the answer? 1 upon what is sin x power? M. 1 more than this power. That is 1 upon m plus 1. Okay. So particularly if either sin x power, suppose if sin x power is 1, then answer is 1 upon 1 more than the cos x power. Suppose if cos x power is 1, then answer is 1 upon sin x power plus 1. That is 1 upon 1 more than the sin x power. Okay. Now here if you look at, here sin x power is how much? 1. Then answer is what? 1 upon 1 more than the cos x power. What is cos x power? 10. 1 more than 10 is 11. So the answer is 1 upon 11. Okay. Now here cos x power is 1. Sin x power is how much? 2000. Here cos x power is 1. Sin x power is how much? 2000. So here cos x power is 1. So the answer is what? 1 upon 1 more than the sin x power. What is sin x power here? 2000. 1 more than 2000 means 2001. So thus the answer is 1 upon 2001. Over. I hope you understand this session. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and ask them subscribe my channel to get more number of videos. Thank you.